In the last video, we set up our dinosaur character to be able to pick up mushrooms and add them to the inventory. But to view the actual amount of mushrooms, we had to use debug mode. Here, we're going to display our scores on the screen, with each score being the amount of mushrooms we've collected. This is what it will look like. In the upper right corner, we've got a small HUD that displays the count of each mushroom type, and when we collect a mushroom, it's added to the score. We set up the score variables, and the ability to increase them in the last video, so if you haven't seen it, the link is in the description. The first thing we need to do is to create a HUD to display the score to the player. We want to show the score for both the orange and pink mushrooms in the upper right corner. Since this layout is contained within one screen, and it won't be scrolling from side to side, we can just add some objects directly to this layer, and they'll stay in place. If the layout did scroll, we'd need to anchor them to the side of the viewport. I'll drag out a new instance of the Mushroom 1 object, and an instance of the Mushroom 2 object. With one of the mushrooms selected, hold down Control, and select the other mushroom as well. In the Properties panel, drop down Size, and we can change the X and Y scale of both objects at the same time. Set the X scale to 50%, and the Y scale to 50% also. Place the orange mushroom on the upper right side of the screen, but leave some space between it and the right edge, so we've got room for the score. Notice the orange mushroom's X position in the Property panel, 834. Then select the other mushroom, and set its X position to 834. Next, select the orange mushroom and check its Y position, which is 33. Select the pink mushroom and set its Y to 40 pixels below the orange mushroom, so 73. Technically, the player could collect these mushrooms, since we used the same objects that we used down here. But in this example, the player has no way of getting up to that area of the screen. Next, we need to add two text objects to the layout to display the scores. Double-click to add a new object, and select Text under the General category. Before inserting it, I'm going to name it Mushroom1_score, and then click Insert. Click to place it in the upper right corner, and resize it so the whole object fits on the screen. Then do the same with a second text object for the pink mushroom score. Double-click. Choose the text object. Rename it to Mushroom2_score. And click Insert. Place it next to the pink mushroom and resize it to fit on the screen. Get it aligned with the mushroom as good as possible, and then click on the score next to the orange mushroom and check its X position. Its X position is 866, so set Mushroom2_score's X position to 866 as well. Click on Mushroom1_score, and go to the text value on the Properties panel, and set it to equals 0. Do the same for the Mushroom2_score text value. Select it, and set the text to equals 0. This will be the default value that the level starts with. Then, as the player collects the mushrooms, we'll update the score accordingly. Let's switch over to the event sheet so we can set that up. Here, we already have the collision events set up between the player and the mushrooms, so all we need to do is add an action to each of these events, updating the scores. Click on Add Action under the Mushroom 1 collision event, and choose the Mushroom 1 score text object. What we want to do is set the text, which we can do with the Set Text action under the Text category. Our scores start with an equal sign, so we need to include that inside the quotes, followed by a space. Then we're going to append the value of the Mushroom1 instance variable. To append a value to a string, outside of the quotes, put a space, then the and symbol, another space, and then the value. To get the Mushroom1 value, we need to reference the player object by typing player, then a period to access all the values available. If I enter the first couple of letters, the mushroom variables come up, and I can select Mushroom1. So the and symbol appends a value onto the string, and the value is the Mushroom1 instance variable connected to the player object. Last, we need to do the same thing for the Mushroom 2 collision. Add an action under the Mushroom 2 collision event, and use the Mushroom 2 score text object. Choose Set Text. And inside the quotes, put an equal sign and a space. Outside the quotes, space, and symbol, space, reference the player object, and select the Mushroom 2 variable. And click Done. If I click F5 to preview the layout and walk over to the mushrooms, the scores are updated as I collect them. You should always update the score in an event that is triggered only once, like a collision event that destroys the object, rather than every frame. If you created an event triggered on every tick and updated the score each frame, you're wasting resources updating values that aren't changing every frame. It's better to update the HUD once when the values have actually changed.